Okay, this time we're doing a Scrawlrbox unboxing. I've already gotten a few of these. I think only one has been from my actual subscription. The rest I had to go back and buy. This should be October's box, but, well, at least I think it is, because I think December's is still on its way. I'm just gonna rip it open like a freaking animal. I just got this in the mail today, and I'm so excited. But I might have to wait to actually do the unboxing, or the art, because I have to go to work later. Everybody just keeps an X-Acto knife on their desk, right? The featured artist in this box is Drawing with Waffles, who is the reason I know about these subscriber art box things. So I had to get it for that. And for two, her favorite color is purple, which happens to be mine as well. So, yay! Oh, it's so pretty. I love her style a lot. So this box is going to be very purple-based, which, you know, as I said, I love purple, so I had to get it because of that, too. Get our supplies out of here. We got two pieces of paper. And this, a little torn up. Oh, well. This came out. We got the Scrawler pin for this being their 50th box they've made, which I think is really cool. Looks like their little Scrawler emblem. Also wanted that. Low-key, high-key wanted that. So there it is. I don't know what I'm going to put this on because I really don't want to lose it. Ever. So there that is. Now we open these wonderful art supplies. I love this little Scrawler sticker. It's so cute. Yeah. We got this candy. Charm of Violet. Got a purple, sparkly Scrawler sticker. Be nice if it was actually like holographic and sparkled, but eh, can't have everything. No artificial colors, so that's 100% real purple that's in there. I wonder if they're grape flavored. Looks like Smarties. That's an interesting flavor. Oh. We have a Derwent paint pen, 0.5, covered in a plastic. There we go. Shed your skin. That looks cool. I don't have a lot of luck with white paint pens, so hopefully I wind up liking this one. Oh, let's get this out of the way. Covering up Ren's beautiful art. There we go. We have a pencil. And I have it upside down. SV Dressen 2000 2.5 equals HB by Faber-Castell. I like the look of this pencil. It looks really cool. Hopefully it draws very well. And we have a Lyra kneadable eraser. It says high quality. It's got a nice little box that it goes in that I cannot open. I'm doing it backwards, I think. Maybe. No? How do you open you? Ah, there we go. So I got another little kneadable eraser. Very squishy. Kind of like opening a pack of bubble gum. There we go. It's very like bubble gum-esque. Oh, that is squishy. Is it a kneadable eraser or a stress toy? Then last but not least, Copic 2 Doodle Pack Purple. Which I'm excited to get this because I need more Copics in my life. I've gotten addicted to them. Which is not a healthy addiction. Because they're freaking expensive. near you. Ah, one stayed behind. So here's our lovely colors. We have the two Copics, BV00, BV04, with medium broad tips and super brush tips. Ooh, those are pretty looking. Although, oh, I'm putting them backwards. That's why the lighter one was going on a darker one. I was very confused for a minute. Okay. Got those. We have Atios Spica, twinkling like the stars, 0.02 pink. I can read. Got some ink on it already. Most people swatch on paper. I swatch on my fingers. Like a freaking pro. Like I said, I'm only a hobbyist artist, so. Then we have a Copic Multiliner in Wine. That is 0.3. I don't know why I keep wanting to say 0.0. Here we go. Very fine point. Let's get this out of the way. I don't want to put anything on it. Put that over on the side. Papers are real smooth. Okay, put this paper over the side and we'll try out our supplies real quick before I have to rush off to work and continue this in another clip that I'll put in the video. So it's not going to be another video, it'll be the same one. But so we're just real quick, I think, try to doodle something and get a feel for this before we actually do our challenge and, you know, get all that going. What do you mean I'm drawing a dragon again? This real scribbly and quick. It's a very friendly serpent. There we go. A nice little bust. I really like that pencil. Stretchy! Ooh. Oh, my wrist just popped. Man, this is fine. Dirty, dirty. That's multi-liner. Okay. So, make sure I'm drawing in frame here. Still not used to my setup. I don't have one that really works, but we're still working with it. The rate this is going, I might just do a separate, like, draw with me thing. Maybe. This turned less from a quick swatch. I'm actually liking it, how it's coming out. Maybe it's just because I made it too big. I really like how smooth this paper is. There we go. Actually, what is this paper? Canson the Wall. 220 GSM. Designed for graffiti artists, illustrators, and designers. Behaves like a real wall. Hmm. see. What should I do? I think a lighter for the body. Let's try out the super brush. Really should have drawn my Fursona shade. This color looks like it's perfect. I was gonna make these like fins, but oh well. There's still time, I guess. I really like this little dude, he's cute. Squeaky markers. Whoops. Good thing this is just a doodle. Squeak, 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 squeak. Eh, maybe I still add the fins. We'll just do that. Boy, that is a very pretty shade of purple. Where's the other one? There it is. So now we'll do the darker. This shade is very pretty, too. Not biased at all. Huh. Go back in with the liner since I forgot this step. There we go. What about the horn? Maybe the darker purple, too. Because I was going to put it down here, but I kind of like how that is, so. Do this number. I used to be really scared of, like, drawing with markers because it was so easy to get uneven tones. Because they dry, and then they'd layer up and darken, and then you had a splotchy mess. But it seems like Copics are really good at evening out when they dry. You just barely see the difference here. So I'm very happy with that. Okay. Let's use this, buddy. How do we use you? You have a nice pink eye, pink glittery eye, there we go. Ooh, and we could do more of this in the center. There we go. And now we can't forget our highlights, of course. There we go. That took a minute to get the ink flowing. Well, it works. Maybe I spoke too soon. It did work. Oh, come on. Why do all white paint pens do this? They always come out the side instead of the tip. Oop. We have a spray. What is it with white paint pens that just have to do that? I don't understand. Oh, well, we got it drawing now. Big old highlight here. A little one here. There we go. Gives the illusion that this little guy or gal is very friendly. So keep drawing. So the problem I had with the Scrawlrbox is that the white just was crap. There we go. Okay, companies, get to making a white paint pen that doesn't come out the side, only comes out the nib. So far, white gel pens seem to be the way to go, because you get this. I have no color coming out at all. God. Except for that. I don't have anything to clean that. Well, we get an explosion and then nothing. The nib just does not give any color. It only does it out the side. In order to do this, I had to get something to splash out the side and then dip the pen in. So all white pens that are not the basic little gel pens are basically dip pens because that's how you have to use them, I guess. Unless there's some magical godly trick that you have found, which makes them actually work. You try to pump it and it comes out the end there instead. Anyways, I'm out of time for this. So, here's my little poor dragon. I forgot where I put the lid. That's on the back. Bit of a mess here. Boy, people can ask questions when I go to work. Let's see if I could fix this real quick. It's supposed to be... Oh, excuse me. It's supposed to be like a quick little, just test the supplies real fast, but I got a little invested in him. I think he's really cute. Might make this a character, don't know yet. But we'll try to cover up the mistake. Definitely my favorite thing from the box, other than the, you know, artwork from the featured artist, is these Copics. They work phenomenal. This, I wound up really liking too. It's got, that eye looks really good. So, the liner. This box was amazing. This was good. This needs a little bit of work. It needs to stop coming out the side of the barrel and actually come down through the nib. I will give it another try, though, because, whoop, I'll throw it around. Like I said, I am kind of in a hurry because I have to go to work in like 10 minutes, so we'll give you another try. I don't dislike it as much as I dislike the Sharpie oil-based white pen thing that was the first pen I ever used that had the pump. You have to shake and pump. Well, we won't get into that disaster. But I'll give it another try. It's got a bunch of bubbles in it. It looks really cool. I don't know if you can see that. It looks really cool in there. But I will come back to this box in the next video. I guess I will separate the video so it doesn't wind up too long, but this is my unboxing of October Scrawlrbox. And I will come back to it. They have a challenge, which is called Dress to the Nines. And I will be doing that on this other piece of paper here that I have. So I'll be drawing something that isn't a dragon. Unless I can draw a dragon lady dressed up. We'll see. Who knows? I might draw this character again, but like anthropomorphic? Maybe. Probably not. Who knows? Well, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video when I actually draw the challenge art, because I really wanted to do that. But I don't have enough time. So I'm going to rush off to work, clean up, get ready, and bleh. Thank you for watching. Bye.